Hi, I'm Adrien Treuille, Director of Product at Snowflake. Now, one of the most exciting new technologies of the generative AI and LLM era is the ability to create chat interfaces that allow even non-expert users to access vast computational and AI powers. I'm going to show you how we can build such an interface inside of Snowflake using Snowflake and Streamlit's new AI chat interface. So, here we are in Streamlit and Snowflake, and I've got an app here running, which just says an LLM chatbot in Snowflake. And in fact, you know, we're going to create your own LLM chatbot in Snowflake. And what we're going to do is use two really cool elements in Streamlit, which we've just released during Summit to allow you to build your own LLM-powered chatbots easily. The first one is called chat message. So we can just say st.chatMessage, and we have to say whether it's a user or a non-user, and we're going to write hello. There we go. And all of a sudden we have a message which says hello, or we could actually have the assistant respond. World. Okay, so we've started to create something that looks a little bit like a chatbot inside of Streamlit. Now I'm going to add another method, which is called chat input. So let's say the prompt, which is what the user says, equals st.chatInput. And now we have a prompt down here at the bottom. And in order to make this look a little bit more interactive, let's just do something with this prompt for now. We'll change these strings to whatever the prompt is. Here we go. And let's run this. Now, whatever the user says will be written in our chat messages. Cool. So these two new elements give us the ability to write our own custom conversational apps inside of Snowflake and share it with stakeholders in our company. In order to do that, we're going to need a little bit more structure. So I'm going to scroll down here to my cheat sheet, and we're going to bring some code over into our app. And I'll tell you what all the pieces of this mean. Okay. So, the first thing that we're going to do is initialize the message history of our chat app. This is basically the memory of what was said by both the user and the assistant, stored in this variable called session state. Okay. Then we're going to take the prompt from the user as we did before, and we are going to append it to both the user and the assistant in our chat message history. Finally, at the end, we're going to render the entire chat message history. So basically, we're going to clear the history, initialize it, take the user prompt, append whatever the user says to the chat history, and then render the entire chat history. So it's starting to really feel like a chatbot. Let's see what this does. Okay, so it starts with the initial message, how can I help, which we initialized right up here. And now we can say something like, hello. And you'll see that the chatbot will respond back with whatever we said. Okay, hello, hello. We're also using another cool feature of chat message, which is the ability to set a custom avatar. All right, now we actually want to do something interesting with these results. So rather than just parroting back whatever the user said, let's actually take that prompt and search for it in a database of job listings. And let's call this our job listings chatbot. Job listings chatbot. All right. So now we're going to search for the prompt in our database, and we're going to get some results. And then we are going to, let's just display those results for now. Okay, cool. So now let's say something new to the chatbot. This is a job listings chatbot. So let's just say maybe what kind of data scientist jobs do you have? Here we go. And now we've outputted 3 data scientist jobs from our database using this embedding search method. Let's actually do something interesting with this. Let's have the chatbot not only remember this response, but actually summarize it for us. So let's, instead of just writing the response, we're going to say the response is whatever we got back from the LLM. And then we're going to take those results and we're going to inject it back into the LLM and ask it to summarize them. Let's see how this works now. What does it take to be a data scientist? So again, we're searching for the embeddings in our embedding database. We are actually going to get a bunch of results. We're going to summarize those results, and then we're going to display it again in line in the chat history. In this case, we have about 10,000 rows of public data about Capital One job listings, and it tells us that when we need a bachelor's degree or military experience, et cetera, et cetera. Let's ask it another question. What about to be a fraud detection specialist? Either a high school diploma, GED equivalent certification, or military experience. So this is so cool. We have actually built a custom, fully programmable chatbot in Streamlit and Snowflake itself. And you can even take this and create a URL to share with your stakeholders in the company. So there you have it, a fully programmable custom chatbot in Snowflake in 41 lines of Python Streamlit. Thank you.